There's no way to guarantee your listings will always appear on the first page of Etsy search results, but there are ways to make sure Etsy SEO gives your listings a little extra love and put them in front of more customers, increasing your sales. SEO stands for Search Engine Optimization. By working on your Etsy store's SEO, you're improving the visibility of your shop and listings on Etsy and other search engines like Google. Basically, the more people see your products, the more likely you are to make sales. There's no way you can trick or outsmart the search engine, and any attempt in doing so might actually hurt your store in the long run. Instead, I'll show you how to work with it. To demonstrate how Etsy's algorithm works, I'll look up some art pieces on the marketplace. To do that, I'll search wall art for living room. In a matter of seconds, a little over 5 million listings pop up. While it might seem like Etsy's just showing me the best-selling items first and the ones with fewer orders last, that's not exactly true. Before I even see anything on my screen, the search engine goes through two phases to determine which listings and in what order it will show me the products. The first stage is called query matching. During this stage, Etsy's search engine looks at the titles and tags of each listing and gathers the one that matched the search query. A search query is a keyword a person has entered in the search bar. Then all of the listings that got selected go through a second stage, the ranking process. Some of the factors that Etsy's search engine looks at when ranking listings is attribute relevancy and listing quality. I'll talk more about these two factors and the ranking process later in the video. As I said, there's no guarantee that you'll always appear on the first page of the search results, even if you do everything right. While it might sound a little disappointing, there's actually a good reason behind it. Etsy's SEO personalizes each customer's experience and shows them the product they're most likely to purchase based on their previous activity on the marketplace. So for example, if you sell bohemian wall art pieces, they'll be shown primarily to people who have bought or browsed similar style products before. And that's a good thing because someone who's interested in minimalist wall art might not be interested in your pieces anyways. So Etsy's search engine connects the right customer to the right product rather than throwing just anything at them and hoping something sticks. So don't focus on the idea of appearing on the first page of every search result for wall art. Focus on refining your store and listings to attract the ideal customer. For your listings to pass the query matching phase, they need to be written according to Etsy's SEO guidelines. So let's look at how to write SEO-friendly Etsy titles and tags. When writing your titles and tags, always keep in mind that you're writing them for a person first, any search engine second. Let's say I'm creating a listing title and tag for this Art Deco-inspired poster. A mistake that I see many people make on Etsy is keyword stuffing the listing titles. This is what a keyword stuffed title looks like. While it contains a lot of descriptive keywords, this title might leave potential customers confused as to what you're selling. Instead, you should make your titles clear and descriptive so people know what the product is just by glancing at the title. Here's how to do that. If you've had your store running for a while, you might have already noticed which keywords perform the best for which products. So when writing the title, focus on one or two of the strongest keywords and leave the rest for the tags. The keyword should also be at the very beginning of the title because the search engine considers words at the beginning of the title more important than the words at the end. Going back to our example, I'll pick the keyword 1920 style poster because that's the best performing keyword for this product. Make the title sound appealing to potential customers. You can do that by adding descriptive keywords that mention the color, size, shape, or material of the product. For example, I can describe my product as a 1920 style poster, large matte print. It looks clean and understandable, and it works for Etsy's SEO. All right, great. Now let's talk a bit more about tags. This is a section where the rest of your keywords should go. Sounds easy enough, but there are a few misconceptions about the best practices of adding tags to your Etsy listings. Let's discuss this. Myth number one, the tags must match the titles. Your tags don't need to match the titles. Instead, you should use tags to write alternative search keywords that people might be searching for to find your product. For example, this is where I'd add keywords like Art Deco poster, living room wall art, Art Nouveau print. Myth number two, you should include plurals and misspelled words in your tags. It's actually the opposite. Etsy's search engine is smart and will account for misspelled words and plurals, as well as different spelling variations of the same word. So you don't need to include misspelled words or plurals in your tags. Focus on correctly spelled, diverse keywords instead. Myth number three, you should repeat the same keywords with minor changes. Just like you should avoid plurals and misspelled words in your tags, you should avoid repeating the same word over and over again. For example, I don't need to write Art Deco art, Art Deco print, Art Deco poster. Instead, add different keywords that people might use to find your art. In my case, these keywords could be Art Deco home decor, Art Nouveau artwork. To sum it up, try to add a variety of keywords to your tags to make sure people can find your products no matter which keywords they type in the search bar. Another piece of information that Etsy's search engine looks at in the first phase of sorting listings is item attribute relevancy. Let's learn more about it. Attributes are additional details you might use to describe your product. From the customer's point of view, they're called filters and they're displayed on the left-hand side of the search results page. Shoppers can use them to narrow down the search results. You can add or update a listing's attributes during the listing process or use the listing editor. It's a good idea to add all the attributes that are relevant to your listings and skip any attributes that don't apply. Correctly added attributes help increase the visibility of your listing as people can choose exactly what they want to find and so they'll find your product more effectively. For example, my poster would go in the wall art category and would fit nicely with the Art Deco style category too, but I definitely shouldn't put it all in the Christmas gift category. While this poster could be a nice Christmas present, it's not really Christmas themed. Once your listings pass the query matching phase, it's important to optimize them to make sure they'll also rank high in the search results. While a keyword optimized listing is a must, having strong visuals and a solid copy is just as important. After all, that's what makes people click on the listing. And the more people look at, like, and purchase your listings, the higher Etsy's algorithm places them in the search results. Why? Etsy assumes that listings that get the most attention are the ones that serve customers' needs the best. First impressions matter, so put your best photo forward. Make sure that the first listing photo is clear, yet eye-catching enough so that people want to take a closer look. Etsy gives you an opportunity to add up to 10 photos or videos to your listing, and you should definitely take this opportunity. But don't just add the same 10 photos. Show your products from different angles, show it alone and with other items. Show it being used and include a video of it in action. When shopping online, people can't touch the product and view it themselves, so your visuals should help them understand how great the product is and give potential buyers an idea of the product's size, texture, thickness, etc. Once you've captured someone's attention with amazing visuals, it's time to reel them in with a good description. Product descriptions help shoppers make decisions if they want to buy a product or not. And the more people who choose to buy your product, the higher your listings are ranked by Etsy's algorithm. When writing your descriptions, make sure to follow these best practices. Write the most important information first. When online shopping, it's pretty frustrating if you have to spend time searching for basic information about a product's size, material, or customization instructions. So make sure all the necessary info is front and center. Instead of just adding a huge wall of text, separate it into paragraphs, add bullet points, and underline when you can. That'll make your text easier to read, and people will be much more likely to get the information they need. There's another way to sweeten the deal for your customers even more: the shipping price. Did you know that 75% of shoppers say that free shipping motivates them to make a purchase? Etsy knows that too, and since they want customers to buy more products, they favor listings with lower shipping fees. Lowering your shipping costs can be tricky, but there are a couple of creative tactics to try. We have a video covering this topic, so make sure to watch it after this. I'll leave a link in the description. Nearly all shoppers read reviews, and the majority consider them an essential resource when deciding whether to buy a product or not. And it's not just your potential customers who are looking for positive reviews. Etsy ranks your listing by reviews, and the better you have, the higher your listings will rank in search results. So make sure to provide an amazing shopping experience for your customers. Listen to them and try to solve any issues that come up to get those 5 shining stars. Last but not least, give people a chance to learn your story. This is your chance to let shoppers know what makes your shop unique. You can include a video or photos of yourself, your workspace, or your work process. Adding an about section increases your ranking score, and that can improve how high in the search results your listings appear. So make sure to share all about how you got started, the inspiration behind your products, and the fun tidbits about your business. You can do this. Implementing a successful Etsy SEO strategy requires a combo of selling products that people are looking for, optimizing your store and listings for their search engine, and being a hardworking seller. Get all 3 ingredients right, and you'll have a recipe to succeed in the Etsy SEO game.